Julia last night, but not you. I could wake up this morning, but not you. I could save you, but not you.
But God
can do what he wants. Amen. And God impregnated a woman, and then she, and the Bible said, she shall bring forth.
Amen. That's right.
A son. Christmas is gone, but Christmas never goes. Amen. But I got another word, I believe. But that's pretty awesome. I don't know about you, amen. But I can go to sleep, don't know I'm asleep. And then wake up. And then got sense. And I got some good sense. That's pretty awesome.
Amen.
Amen. I don't know what you think, but I know what I'm saying. In the book of Ephesians,
amen.
Be with us as we continue in God's word. We are one.
Well.
Stand with us, not too much trouble. Amen. My soul has been blessed.
Amen.
Already.
Thank you, Lord.
Woo. Ephesians, the fourth chapter. I know we praise and we worship and we get excited, but I do need to teach a little bit. Because that verse, chapter 4, has a therefore. That means it's something else God wants us to talk about. You know, we're just going to praise Him one day. Praise the year for him every day. I therefore, prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that you walk worthy of your vocation wherein you are called. All lowliness and meekness with long suffering, forbearing one another in love.
Mm-hmm.
We are to promote love.
All right.
Endeavoring to keep the unity of spirit in the bond of peace.
Yeah.
There is one body, one spirit, and even your call and one hope of your calling.
Mm-hmm.
One Lord, one faith, and one baptism.
Yeah.
I'm so glad. Amen. We baptize one this month.
Amen.
Amen. That's one of the missions of the church.
All right.
One God and Father of all who is above all.
Yeah.
Say that again. Say that with me. Above all.
Above all.
Whatever you think you are, God is above
you.
Amen. Amen. And He's above the White House as well.
Amen.
He's above the State House.
Amen.
As well as our house.
Amen.
To all and in you all. Lord, bless your word today. Bring forth clarity to your word. Give your preacher preaching power. Let me preach with clarity. And then God, edify your people today with your word. Inspire us with your word.
Yeah.
And then God, in all that we do, we'll bring glory to your name.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, I do pray. Thank you. Amen. May be seated in the presence of the Lord as we continue starting the new year off right. Amen. We are one. And one, we are in that right.
Amen.
You are a Christian, you understand that we are children of God.
All right. All right.
We are in the family of righteousness.
Amen.
Even though we don't always do what's right, we are still in the family of righteousness. That means what we are being covered by what Jesus did for us out of own Calvary. Don't let nobody fool you and say that you have to be perfect. You don't sin in this world. Whoever told you that was sinning right then. Because the Bible said we all come sin and come short of the glory of God. Amen. And not if you didn't do something yesterday morning, you did some yesterday evening. Or during the course of the day, if you didn't do that this morning, guess what? If you keep living, you're going to do something today that's not right with God. That's why the word said, amen, confess your faults before God. He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins. That means what he will do it, and he will do it right. He may not do it the way that we want him to do it, but he'll do it just right. And starting the year off right, looking at today, amen, somebody remember that there is a word that I need for the rest of the week at the church. something that you need, not just what you want. You're looking for something that you need. Look at your neighbor and say, we are one. Amen. We're walking the right way. Amen. We have certain high standards from the Lord as we walk the path of righteousness in his name. Let me say that again. I said, the Lord requires high standards from us because what? He's the one that died for us. He's the one that went in the grave for us. He's the one that blessed us when nobody don't tell nothing about us. He's the one that when the doctor misdiagnosed, God is the one that step up and heal us. He's the one that feeds us when we're hungry. He's the one that heals us when we're sick. He's the one that comforts us when we need comforting. So therefore, he has authority to set up step. You just can't live any kind of way. And then say you're a child of God. And say you're on the way to heaven anyhow. It just don't work that way. Amen. But if the Holy Spirit is in you, you will live some kind of holy. If he's in you, you'll praise him sometimes. You'll worship him sometimes. You'll pray sometimes. You'll need sometimes. Why? Because he's holy. And what's in you will come out. I said, what's in you will come out. I have a witness here. You're full of hell, it'll come out. You're full of heaven, it'll come out. Sometimes. I didn't know it, but she was hitting me.
All right.
I might not have understood it all, but thank God, she whooped me. That means she helped me. Now, when Daddy whooped me, it almost killed me.
All right.
Because his hand was about that big. She laughed. Amen. We have trained us in high standard because we are living in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah. Since we are prisoners of Christ, yeah. Right. We are worthy of his call.
All right.
Because we owe God more than we could ever pay.
Right.
I said we owe God more than we could ever pay. If you're a child of God, you owe him a prayer. You owe him coming to church. You owe him, amen, reading the Bible. You owe him doing what's right. You owe him loving one another. You owe him a praise. You owe him a worship. Because what? He's been so good.
Amen.
Help me.
Yes, sir.
So we are. And we can't pay him. I know we can't.
I know. That's all right.
I know I can't. I don't have enough money. How about you? You gotta have Jesus. What little bit we got, it can be gone real quick. I tell you what, teach them all. You need time.
Good
work. Good work. You know why? When you're tired, you'll be like the woman with the meal button.
Yeah.
You can reach and never go
empty.
Do I have some witness in the house? I said God will show up when you at least expect him, and when you think your limitation, and when you think your resources are gone, God will step up and God will bless you every time. He said, try me. Non-titles. That trust God, you're Christian, but you're still wrong. Amen. You've been around a while, but you're still wrong. You've been in the church a while, but you're still trying to hold on. And you're still giving $1.20 in action for 1950.
Oh, yeah. Look out.
But listen to what God did for the world. This is beholding so much we can't pay. I want to get your amen back. Amen. This is what he took his dear son and he provided a perfect righteousness for us.
Yes.
He provided